Ronald DeWolf.
Ronald, pardon me, Ronald DeWolf.
Ronald Edward DeWolf.
Are you the natural son of L. Ron Hubbard?
Yes, I am.
This is how your father originally gained his main source of income?
Yes, it was. But the problem there is a lot of his writing. He didn't really write as many words as he said he did. Through the early 50s, he used to tell everybody that he had written 7 million words of fiction. But in fact, it probably never exceeded 1 million words. And that a great deal of his income came from my mother, who and my grandfather, his father, who supported him.
Then much of it has been written and said about your father as a figment of his imagination, would you?
That's quite correct. My father's been married 3 times. I know in Scientology literature and what he tried to lead other people to believe in his writings of his biographies that he's only been married once to Mary Sue Hubbard, but he's been married 3 times. The true history of L. Ron Hubbard should come out and should be known by people. I'm talking about the documented facts and the actual occurrences of his lifetime, because he has built up over the years, since 1950, a great mystique, a great amount of false and imaginary data. I could say flatly that 99% of what my father wrote about his own life and what he had done is false.
Was he really in the war and shot up and healed himself with his own mind? And
he was in the Navy during World War II, but he wasn't shot up.
Okay, what about his educational
background?
Never wounded
or blinded. Excuse me, sir.
Sir, are you finished?
I said he was never wounded or blinded.
Would you like to go into how far in college did he indeed go, and what degrees has he had?
He spent a few months, as far as college is concerned, at George Washington University. And one of the major points that he has said that he has said that he has a degree in engineering. At one point, there was a degree in nuclear engineering. Now, of course, that changed. As far as any nuclear engineering is concerned, he only took one semester, and he received an F, as in failure, for the one semester. The incidents in Dianetics, Modern Science and Mental Health came from generally from his imagination, and also the at least 2 attempted abortions on my mother. One I observed when I was around 6 or 7, and his other activities with other women. But as far as any research is concerned, he has said at various times that he had spent 30-some years researching it, but he didn't.
Right. It says that the book preys on mentally impaired or ill people, and Dianetics' book represents its mythology will cure more than 70% of all man's ills, and he's claimed to have cured cancer, tuberculosis, arthritis, heart disease, retardation, and you can increase your IQ and et cetera. Do you think that he has been successful in any of these things?
He claimed it cured anything and everything.
Then the list could be larger, et cetera.
No, you see, Dianetics and Scientology, I can back up on this later a little bit, but Dianetics and Scientology is, according to Dad, the one and only true path to freedom, the one and only true alleviation of any aberration or human problem. It is the solution to anything that a human being may want to do, or he may have any sickness and illness. I know that over the years, I can remember in the 50s where we were putting across it would cure anything, including falling hair and dandruff, and but the lawyers and attorneys and the government were getting very uptight and very upset about us using the word cure. because the very first Dianetic Research Foundation in Elizabeth, New Jersey in 1950, that's one of the reasons they've got closed up, and while Dad had to move on to Wichita, Kansas. But the main idea here was that we had to alter what we were selling out. There's a recurring theme here throughout his life here of what I've always termed fleeing in the night. That is that he grabbed whatever cash he could from the Elizabeth, New Jersey Foundation and went to Wichita, Kansas. And there, with a Don G. Purcell and some other people, formed up the Dianetic Research Foundation in Wichita, Kansas. Sarah and my father got into a tremendous divorce battle where Sarah was claiming the same things, as an example, that he had been doing with my mother many years before that, which is beatings, attempted abortions, etc. He injecting air into his heart with a hypodermic and also poisoning a bottle of whiskey. Both of them untrue and pure fabrication by my father. My father's only had one basic driving goal in any organization, and that is total and complete control. He could never share responsibility, sit on a board of directors, or even operate any way in a group. And he felt he was being constrained, and he thought he was being confined. And he, quite literally, he was in terrible financial straits because he spent money like water. All of a sudden, one day, my father Mary Sue, they emptied all the bank accounts. Now, he was only able to sign on one small bank account. But I remember my father talking about how he had gotten other people to empty them, and how he had forged the names on checks. But anyway, he had emptied the entire bank of all the bank accounts of the Wichita Dianetic Research Foundation, and did another one of his fleeing in the nights to Phoenix, Arizona. My father only felt good with incredible amounts of cash with him. And I remember, to jump forward slightly, I remember being, when I first arrived there in 1952 to start working with him very closely, that he kept shoe boxes of money in his closet, all cash. And they had, I believe, somewhere around five or six shoe boxes with $25,000 apiece in them in his closet. That, by the way, is something he's always done, which is kept an incredible amount of cash close at hand so he could grab it and run. My father only knew how to do one thing, and that was to destroy people. I mean, he would not, he could not do anything lightly. To him, anybody who did anything against him, criticized him, he would just flat go after their throat.
And does he have any background, to your knowledge, to scientific background that auditing could be a plausible and worthwhile medical, or
no, of course not.
Or
no,
the just something he made up then. Auditing is just something he made up, or
yes.